Yes,
Hey
ma'am.
guys, this is Trinity, and today I will show you one of the most advanced grappling escape moves. This move can also be used in an offense way while grappling, and it is very effective in street fights when the fight goes to the ground or the clinch. It is called tickling. I know you all heard of tickling, but did you know it is a very effective move? Especially in a street fight without no rules, but it is a move they will not allow in grappling tournaments. This move is so effective that you can use it to defeat many grapplers in a street fight, even if you don't know how to grapple. You might be asking yourself, if this kid is so good at grappling, why does he need to tickle his opponent? And the answer is, in a street fight, you want to use the least amount of strength and energy and effort, and you want to finish the fight as quick as you can, because the cops might be coming, or you could be crowded place and someone could sneak up on you while you are fighting. Also, while you are fighting multiple attackers, you do not want to be rolling on the ground with your opponent, but if the fight goes to the ground, you want to finish the fight as fast as you can, then get back on your feet. And remember, there is no such thing as a fair fight. If you go out there with the mindset that everything will be fair, you already lost. Your opponent might even poke your eyes to come out of a jujutsu move. In a real fight, there is no such thing as a time limit or a referee or rules or tapping out. I once witnessed a real fight, a street fight. The one guy put the other guy in an armbar, and the other guy tapped out, but his opponent still broke his arm. He showed him no mercy. He didn't care if he tapped out or not. It is not a tournament. In most street fights, you want to avoid the fight going to the ground as much as you can. Even if you are an amazing grappler, too many stuff you might not want to deal with, like headbutting and many more. I'm not saying grappling is not effective in street fights. It is very effective. Also, boxing is very effective in street fights too. I suggest that you know how to grapple and box and kick very effective. Fighting only has 4 range, and you want to be good at all 4 ranges. If you can only fight on your feet and a wrestler takes you down on the ground, you will be like a fish out of water, hopeless. Also, if you are a grappler and you can't take your opponent to the ground and he has better stand-up game, then you will be handicapped and you will lose. And remember, it is always better to have someone as a friend than an enemy. Sometimes it is even better to have neither a friend or an enemy. It is better for a warrior to travel alone. Here's an experiment you can try. Here I'm holding my dad's finger. I have to try to break his finger, and when he says go, but right away he's gonna begin to tickle me. This is to show you how effective tickling is in fighting. It doesn't matter how big your opponent is or how strong he is. Tickling has to do with your nervous system. When you tickle someone, it affects every nerve in their body. It affects their whole entire nervous system. I would rather to be punched than tickled. It's the most annoying thing, but remember, this technique will not work on everyone. Not everyone is ticklish, but most people are, and I suggest you learn to fight effectively and not just depend on tickle technique. Tickling is just a tool you can add to your toolkit. Did you know in ancient times tickling was a very effective method when torturing someone to get them to reveal a secret? Many times it was more effective than beating them for them to talk. Also, tickling someone for an extremely long time can make them extremely ill. And thank you, and now we will end off with showing you some extras.
See, so you do that little John Jones? So you're supposed to pretend you go, huh? Come with it,
Mom, I would love to fight John Jones. Actually, I'm thinking about going up that way to visit him.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Are you down doing something wrong? I'm staying still. I gotta move around.
ひどれか。